old school RuneScape has potential to become an esport. Right off the bat, I want to address this thought you're having. Jim, what the hell do you know about esports? What the hell do you know about esports? Okay? What have you done? What do you know? Shut up. Just shut up for a second, okay? Let's just talk about this. If you haven't played RuneScape since you were running around Lumbridge with a shitty chef's hat, swinging around a bronze sword, killing cows, you've missed a lot. There's been a lot of ruckus lately within the player base and its relationship to Jagex. It's like a weird middle school relationship type deal. No eye contact. That's like really the worst thing you could do. The passive aggressiveness is just through the roof, stemming from discussions about PvP. It's like a very sensitive subject right now. You probably shouldn't talk about it, which is why I'm gonna talk about it. If you're gonna understand anything I'm saying today, we need to go back and take a look at some things that have formed this shit show that we're currently in at the end of 2020.
But first,
big thank you to the sponsor of today's video, Bespoke Post. Bespoke Post is a monthly subscription type beat. They've got these boxes. Each box has a value of about $70. You get to choose which box you want each month. You guys wanna see the thing that I got this month? Check this out. You ever seen something like this before? Got some like Lord of the Rings engravings on it, man. I got the Forge package. It also came with a sheath. It's like a sword if you think about it. Ever since I started playing CSGO, knives just kind of like fascinate me for all the wrong reasons. Boxes are perfect for gifts. I know just about everyone in here is doing last minute Christmas shopping after Christmas. Perfect gift for the dads. They've got shaving cream, CBD oil, sweaters. I got myself a box of cigars. More knives, bags, glass sets. Maybe you need a shovel. I don't know what you're up to. The box is change each month. It's a good time. A good old-fashioned quirky time.
Do yourself a favor, click that link in the description and get 20% off your first monthly box when you sign up. And make sure to use code J1MMY at checkout.
Thanks to Bespoke Post for sponsoring today's video. Let's get back to it. Bringing up PvP is like bringing up politics at the dinner table with your family. There's gonna be arguments, there's gonna be vulgarities thrown at each other, people are gonna say things they don't really mean, and at the end of the day, neither side really knows what they're talking about. PvP has been neglected in old school RuneScape because it is such a sensitive thing to make tweaks and changes to. The implications of fucking up a PvP update are immeasurable. So Jagex is kind of like, I'm not gonna touch that, fuck you. We've got this thing in the game called Bounty Hunter. We did have this thing called Bounty Hunter. Players would get each other as targets while they're in the wilderness. They'd have a task to complete while fighting each other, and there would allegedly be rewards for killing the player. It's a lot more complicated than that. That's the gist. Bounty Hunter is the sole reason I learned how to PvP in the first place. I made 3 videos on PKing, and it was some of the most fun I've ever had in the game. But then, just like every other moneymaker in RuneScape, dickheads found a way to manipulate it. People were boosting, making bot accounts that would boost for them. People were selling themselves as kills. It defeated the purpose of what Bounty Hunter was supposed to be. There was a lot that needed fixing, a lot that needed tended to. Rather than cooperating with the content creators giving constant feedback in document after document, meeting after meeting, working to fix the Bounty Hunter system and giving the attention it needs, it's gone forever. It's never coming back. Bounty Hunter is no longer with us. There was too many complications and they thought, you know what, let's just get this weight off our shoulders and take it the fuck out of the game. See you later, Bounty Hunter. It was fun while it lasted. I miss you. And we still get PvP updates, kind of. Last Man Standing got a rework pretty recently. The Revenant Caves, I guess, are pretty recent. Clans would charge players an entry fee and they would give you their protection since they just kind of swarmed that world and anyone who wasn't under their protection was instantly piled and murdered by all of them. This went on for years. I can't make this up. This was insane how long this went on. Oh yeah, there was a dragon spear ordeal making PvP literally unplayable. Anyone who entered the PvP area could do nothing about it and was frozen indefinitely until they died. That got fixed after 10 days of figuring out probably the only solution to that problem. No matter how much noise is made by the PvP community, Jagex does not take that extra step of effort it would take to really solidify a true PvP experience that would last longer than it has. It's kind of pathetic, if we're being honest. And all of these factors leads into why the attempt at esports has completely failed over the years. And some of you might be thinking, well, that's because Jagex doesn't care for esports. Why would they want to do an esports? They're doing fine. They've got leagues. People aren't really focused on PvP anyway. But here's the thing, jackass. In June 2019, somewhere around there, they hired a head of esports. I won't go into too much detail about that. I'll just let you infer. how that went. Now, Jagex has made attempts to develop some sort of esport and running events that kind of resembled the format of an esport. So let's talk about the big one, the one that's gotten the most attention and the most traction out of every event that they've tried, Deadman Mode. Players would have 1 month to qualify within the top 2,000 players with their total skill level. Those 2,000 players participated in an invitational, and those 2,000 players would start from scratch and have 1 week to become the best and essentially be the last one standing. A week of sleep deprivation, doing the same quests they've done dozens of times, training the same skills over and over again. That week would end in the big final hour where all the players would gather in a certain area as the map Fortnited until they were all dead and there was one person standing who would be claimed the winner of the tournament. Yeah, that was a good idea. Here's what that looked like.
Pretty difficult to actually call them out because names are going to vary, and just in general, it's going to be difficult to realize who's who and everyone's in maximum gear.
Yeah, they can't even capture this hit splat orgy in its entirety because the game engine has no idea what to do with itself when there's this many people in one area. I have some sort of comprehension of what's going on here because I've played the game for 15 years. Somebody who is new to the game or is trying to get into the game and make them watch this, they're gonna beg and plead you to watch literally anything else. This isn't enjoyable to watch. This is funny to watch because it's just a giant shit show and no one can tell what's going on. How do you cast this? And this is going on for an hour. This is the big grand finale, the big shabam at the end of the entire week. This is what everyone is waiting for right here. The whole week of milking content on Twitch and YouTube comes down to this right here. There's so much wrong with this being the big grand finale. If Jagex still to this day thinks that this right here holds potential to be an esport of their game, they're out of their fucking minds. Now, in earlier tournaments, this is what it looked like until the last person remained. In the last two tournaments that they did, they actually had this idea of isolating the last 256 players and having them do 1v1 fights until it was the final two. Having that bracket sort of system worked. I mean, there was still a lot of luck involved in that last final hour when about 1,900 people got eliminated through that. And people called this clan man mode because the clans would do the same thing here that they do in the Revenant Caves. If you weren't a member of a clan, you would be forced to associate yourself with a clan and probably give a cut to them if you were to win. Otherwise, they'd just fucking murder you. Skill could only get you so far. Imagine taking a week off of work, sleeping 3 hours a day, just to have 10 17-year-olds throw fucking exploding chinchillas at you and wipe all your progress and eliminate you in the matter of seconds. No amount of skill or talent could save you from that type of hazard. Esports are about talent and skill and showing off something really cool that the average player would not be able to pull off. The 1v1s did that to an extent, but still, there were probably people that could have made that way more entertaining that got knocked out in the big final hour when they couldn't do anything. I think the closest Jagex ever got to presenting a real esport was on November 24th, 2018 for the All-Stars PvP Championship. It was the first and only time they ever did something like this. And even though it went on a little longer than they expected with a 9.5-hour stream, it was such an enjoyable event. We had 16 content creators competing against each other. There was four groups. They all did a round robin system, best of three fights. It was cool to see, but there was a lot wrong with that tournament.
Next, it will be signed by a professional esports team. That would be very
Fuck you, Kevin.
Best of three for a round robin with 16 players, that's pretty brutal. They could have easily spread that in a 2 to 3 days to widen their audience, market it more, give people a chance to watch it on different days. There was a lot of missed opportunity there, a lot of guinea pig mistakes, not to mention giving the participants a chance to fucking sleep.
The stream was supposed to be done at like 9 or 10 p.m. I don't think we left the studio until like 3:30 a.m.
I think rather than the dynamic, I think it was more the presentation that gave it that esports feel. They put so much effort into presenting this. That's what made it feel like an esport. The time they took to make the graphics to introduce the players, the transitions they had in person at their studio, it felt official, it felt planned, it felt like it was a big deal. But how could they have turned this into an esport? Let me show you what I'm thinking. Instead of this, let's do a little something like this. Four teams of four. Every PvP event so far has catered to either 1v1s or a big last man standing type dynamic. Never once has any of it been catered towards small teams, which is a damn shame because that is the key to stemming an esport out of old school RuneScape. That's a wild idea, Jim. Don't you understand how much work would have to go into developing a concept? Look, I need you all to get something through your head. Every good idea, every good invention, every good PvP game mode, no matter if it's a first-person shooter or a medieval clicking game, it's a stolen idea. Nothing is truly original. And that's exactly how we're gonna do this. Let's look at the world's most popular esports game, Counter-Strike Global Offensive. Five-man teams, attackers and defenders. A game consists of rounds to determine the winner. How about an in-game economy that determines the gear that players would be able to have between rounds? Imagine the first round of any game mode, everyone's just got DDSs. The DDS round. It's a lot like the pistol round, saving up for better armor or a spec weapon. AGS is an op type beat, coming in hot, clutching around, specking a 73, and the fucking crowd goes wild, dude, making a three-lane map. Kind of like the one that we already have. Castle Wars has just been alone by itself in the corner of the world map, just sitting there collecting dust. No attention given to it. When in fact, Castle Wars has been the golden ticket to introduce an esport to this game for over a fucking decade. Now, Castle Wars in its current state? No. That could not be an esport. There's a lot wrong with the game mode itself, but all of the mechanics are there. Now, there's a lot of stuff that I could suggest, little bits and pieces, but rather than do that, I've brainstormed an entire game mode, and I'm gonna run you through it just to show you there could be an esport coming out of old school RuneScape easier than people think. I drew up this game mode myself, came up with it, and by that, I mean I stole more shit from CSGO and just translated it into RuneScape because that works and there's no reason why we can't.
Castle Wars map. Not the whole map. Half of it. Two sides. Five players on each team. Knights, bandits. Knights are in the castle, they're defending the flag. Bandits spawn in the middle. They're infiltrating the castle and bringing it back to their own spawn. We've got three lanes. North Gate, South Gate, and Underpass. At the spawns, each team has gear and weapons unique to their side to choose from. They've got 30 seconds to buy a loadout with their individual economies. Weapons and armor are designated a certain amount of points within the chest, alongside utility like barricades, explosive potions. When the 30 seconds are up, the teams rush into position. Both sides have to execute some sort of strategy. The knights are gonna have to put up some defensive positions. The bandits are gonna have to decide if they want to stack one lane or if they want to spread them out. The strategies can go a million different ways. Meanwhile, the economy is gonna be sprinkled into the gameplay. Kills are X, flag carries are Y. Winning team gets a winning bonus of points. Loser gets small baby loser wimpy bonus. You get the point. The game mode could be best of 16 or first to 9 round wins. So after round 8, the teams would switch sides and have a chance at both defending and attacking. What's the incentive? The same initial incentive that Shooty Gun Game had and still has. Achieving ranks. Trust me when I say a rank labeling a player's skill set, although not always accurate, can become more than enough incentive to get better at the game and increase their rank.
Can't wait to go to Silver 4 from this.
It's a pride slash ego slash I need my dignity back thing.
Are you okay? I haven't heard a word from you.
I was in a deep state of depression thinking about your rank.
One way to do this would be through an ELO rating system that could be developed for this game mode. It's been used in esport heavy games such as Overwatch, League of Legends, and Guild Wars, just to name a few. Players that form teams can track their team rank through something as simple as win count or win to loss ratio, as long as a proper competitive matchmaking system was put into place. You'll notice my incentives did not talk about a reward shop. Jagex, please, for the love of God, stop putting alkables or anything tradable whatsoever in reward shops. I'll even say items such as the halo would cause for leeching. This is not a money-making method for mains or Iron Men. This is not something anyone needs to grind to get a best in slot for their pure. This serves one purpose and one purpose only. Introduce a true competitive scene for old school RuneScape with a system that provides fair and balanced matchmaking for players of different skill sets. A new player learning to PvP in the bronze tier would never go up against someone who's been PKing regularly for a couple years in the mithril tier. A regular occurrence in minigames like Last Man Standing. A proper, balanced, competitive environment would be able to provide new players with an actual opportunity to learn PvP on fair grounds and give experienced PKers a chance to climb the ranks and make a name for themselves in a competitive scene.
Look, I'm not the best at this game, nor am I the most knowledgeable, but I'm gonna use that to my advantage because I play other games. I see how other games operate. The other day, Astralis was playing Team Liquid, and it was such an anticipated match, and that was 10 players bringing in over 100,000 people to watch them. Imagine a team, 5 all-stars, a team that was developed who's just been stomping the competition, and then the underdog of 5 other people come in and play each other. That's something to tune into. I know I've shit-talked clans during this video, but not leaving them in the dust, they would have the opportunity to have these five all-stars within their team, and these guys would be representing their entire clan and their entire organization. I keep comparing Counter-Strike. Jim, you love Counter-Strike, we get it. You play the fucking game, but the reason I'm bringing it up is because it works and it's fun to watch. The interface of it is extremely easy to look at. It's easy to understand, not to mention the camera work, dude. Jesus Christ. I don't think I've seen more abysmal camera work. They have these Oculus orbs that are capable of doing so much, and no one knows how to fucking use them, dude. And I know for a fact there's ways to do it because Goody, Ronin, has developed codes of transferring camera angles from one to another in a smooth transition. It's possible, they just don't fucking do it. Camera work is so important in a visual presentation of an esport, and they've lacked it every single time they've tried. I think esports are the key to keeping this game alive and introducing a whole new element to it that we've never seen. Scratch what you think you know and start looking elsewhere and see what works. There's so much potential here. All we have to do is show a little effort and a little support. I believe in you, Jagex. I know there's a lot of smart cookies over there or Jagex HQ that can make something like this happen easily. Maybe not easily. I don't know how easy it would be. It'd probably be pretty hard, but it'd be worth it, trust me. I think we can make something work. I think we can actually build something amazing out of what we have to work with already. But that's all I've got today, so I guess I'll see you later. God, esports are cool. All right, bye.
Don't even look at that flag. I swear to God. No. Put it down. God damn it.